So there are 30,000 people with an intellectual disability in Ireland, and this is the first time we've ever had an older population of people with an intellectual disability live to old age. So the intellectual disability supplement to the Irish Longitudinal Study on Ageing, known as IDS-TILDA, is the first study of its kind to have ever been conducted in Ireland, or indeed anywhere in the world, where we have included a population of people with lifelong or intellectual disabilities in tandem with a generic ageing study. We're following 10% of the total intellectual disability population, that's over 750 people aged 40 years and over. And some of the most concerning findings to date have been, for instance, the difference in dementia between over the three-year period between wave one and wave two in people with Down syndrome. We have the prevalence increasing from 19% to over 30% in wave two. Contrastingly, different to the generic population or the general population, where the prevalence of dementia is about 4.3 to 8.3% in people aged 65 and over. We found that the prevalence of osteoporosis doubled over the three-year period from 8% to 16%. But even of greater concern was that in this wave, we did objective measurement of bone density, and we found that 70% or 7 out of every 10 people with an intellectual disability had either osteoporosis or osteopenia. So we're seeing, you know, a lot of issues around eye disease. Obesity is also a major problem. Low levels of exercise. I suppose a good news story is that smoking and drinking are lower than we see in the general population. We found that hypertension or high blood pressure was 50% lower in people with intellectual disability compared to the general population. This is very interesting, and I suppose given the fact that this is a population who had many of the risk factors for cardiovascular disease in terms of very high levels of overweight and obesity and inactivity, yet we are not seeing the cardiovascular picture that we see in the general population. So it's very interesting to understand as we move forward what are the factors perhaps driving heart disease, and perhaps populations like people with intellectual disability can help and increase our understanding. Government policy in Ireland, similar to elsewhere, is very much focused on the movement of people from more institutional or congregated settings into community-based accommodation. And this is perceived as something to be very positive and will impact on quality of life for people with intellectual disability. However, this study confirms that movement to the community in no way guarantees community integration. And many people who are living in the community were no more integrated than those who were living in more institutional or congregated settings. So it is critical that we prepare communities to respond and understand the needs of this population, which are different. Many of this population, of course, have huge difficulty in communicating, making their needs understood. So we need to educate general healthcare professionals in the conditions which are common and somewhat different than perhaps they're more accustomed to in supporting the general elderly population. Older people with an intellectual disability rated their health as very good, and I think this is positive. However, we are aware from the report that this is a population that have serious challenges with respect to their health. And unless that we can address some of these challenges, they're likely to live a poor quality of life and poor health in old age. So ageing in poor health, I think, is an empty prize. The IDS-TILDA report provides the platform to raise the visibility and the needs and experiences of people with intellectual disability as they grow older. And I think it ensures that there is evidence to underpin policy and also to help us to understand how we're achieving the key targets set out in those policies. So not only can we evaluate or ensure that we have added years to life for people with intellectual disabilities to grow old, but also, and critically important, that we have added life to years.
Well, with the study, it's important for us to, so it helps the researchers to get more of an insight to what it's like for us and how we can cope with certain issues in our lives as well. I needed to find out stuff from myself as well, like to get, if I was to go to a doctor or anything, to get proper answers to health issues and all like that. And to kind of see, if I didn't get proper answers, what right would we have to get all that information as well? So that's why I found it important for me to be involved. It's important for the research to be done so it can help other services to find out what way they should treat people with ID and how they can support them, like, or if they can get out and do activities and everything else, and that they're capable of doing stuff like getting working in ordinary jobs like ordinary people as well. I actually enjoyed working with the TILDA office, even though I was supposed to be there just on a work experience, and I ended up there 7 months. So it was an experience, and it's given me the confidence to do what I need to do with my life as well, to get to go and join clubs like I did there on Thursday nights. So it is a good thing to do, and I enjoyed it very much.